So that got us off to a good start. I'm gonna pull the dashboard off, if you will, off, and then I'm gonna get the, whoa. Oh boy, we are leaking gas. So I think we've got a stuck float. So it's a good thing we're pulling the carb off. Let me shut the fuel off at the tank. Oh. Looks like the tank is leaking also. So we've got a couple of things to address. Washer for this. All right, so this is hooked in to the choke lever. So how would this come off? Oh, that was easy. Looks like that will. Got it. Okay. So here is the fuel line that is clipped on with the zip ties. So let's get that pulled off. And then we'll take the carb off and get it to the bench. I'm sure the float's in bad shape, so we'll see what's inside of it. I'm also not opposed to completely replacing the fuel line while I'm here. Ten millimeter nut. That's going to be hard to put back on. Try to catch that nut as it comes out. Got it. Nut and the washer. All right, so remember how this is oriented. It goes into the top. Down, hooked. So let's pour this gas out and pop the bowl off. I'm sure we'll find exactly what we think we're gonna find. I'm gonna guess there's probably a lot of old gas still sitting in there. I know it is two-stroke mix, but not that color, and definitely smells varnish, so let's put it on a white. It's no good. Let's open her up. I gotta be careful I don't blow the gaskets out. I don't have another one.
moment. Try if you can to make it last.
Oof. Yep, I think we found the problem. Alright, so we're going to do a full clean out on this. I am surprised the float is moving very nicely. Oh, the float moves, but it looks like the needle and seat is not. So, let's dive in and see what we can find. First. That is not good. So we're going to put some brake parts cleaner in there. Let that soak. It's a soaker. I don't know if you can see in there. Do you see that? I don't know what that is in there. I don't know if that's supposed to be in there. Let's try to pick it out. Well, that could be part of the reason why we experience the performance issues. Let's pull the float out. Gasket actually looks really good. Yep, and there's the needle and seat. As you can see, that is... did not want to move. Can see through it, that's good. Off the camera will show that, but still give it a quick blast anyway. All right, we're through. See if I can get something in there to pull that one out. All right, so this one is under on the side. Not bad. Still needs a cleaning though. So I feel good about that one. Let's get that one in. We'll put the washer back into the spacer. That'll get pushed back in deeper once we put the bowl back on. So there's the needle. Okay, that looks really clean. But let's pull the seat out. Get this air vent off and get that cleaned. All right, so we got the bowl cleaned up real nice. Got that thing back in there. We'll get the float and the pin in, the needle. So let's see. Yep. Hard to tell, but the needle is now free. There it is. And it's back together. Let's go take a look at that gas leak out of the gas tank. So we were leaking gas, which looks like it's coming out of the rubber bushing. So I'm going to take off the tank and we'll see what we got. I'm sure that's plenty dried out. So I pulled the petcock off, and it's seen better days. You could see the screen. It's pretty torn up that's in there, so I think just the rubber gaskets all dried out. The tank is in good shape, but let's see if we can find some parts online and get a replacement. I don't think there's anything I can put on there to make it leak proof again. Or maybe I can find something similar. Again, it doesn't have to be even this exact tank. Well, now that we got a nice clean carb, let's put it back on. So this side was that goofy side where you couldn't fit a tool in. Well, it actually went on pretty good. Okay, we're back on. I wonder if I forgot to put anything on. Probably. Where'd this go? Go there. Sure did. Now we're back in business. since the gas tank is leaking, I'm going to try to make a temporary one and drill a hole in the cap of this bottle and then see if I can't just wedge that in there nice and tight to where it won't leak. And we can at least run this a little bit more, make sure the carb is doing fine. So let's do that. All right. It is definitely tight, but not sure if it's tight enough. Put a little bit of gas in it, see if it holds. Yep. Probably turn the valve off. Cool. It's holding. It'll be enough for us to at least test it. I now have my temporary fuel tank installed. It's a water bottle hanging from the handlebars. Believe it or not, it doesn't leak. So we're going to put some fuel in it. Hopefully we're not going to flood the carb. The needle and seat's going to be cleaned out now and moving just fine. So let's put just a little bit in here. Okay. I'm going to turn the petcock. We're right on that line. Oh, look at that. The petcock's leaking. So it looks like the petcock is the problem. Let me see if I can't tighten that up a little bit. Well, I turned the fuel back on. And it doesn't appear to be leaking. So that's good. So I'll get the petcock opened again. Got a couple of drips here and there, but nothing crazy. Oh wow, it took the whole thing. Oh, I see what's happening. So that hole right there, when I put fuel in it, pours out. And I remember there was a plate that was in side that snapped on there, that it was somehow connected. So I got to take a look in there and see if something came loose or what, but there should be nothing coming out of there. Okay, we're back in the carb. So let me pull the float off again. Needle dropped right out. That actually works. So this was the piece. That I took out. And this is where it's leaking, so maybe the float isn't working. I don't know. But it's should have fluid come out there. Yep. I don't know. I would think that would be an overflow. So if there's too much fuel in it, it's going to come out there. So maybe, so maybe the float doesn't work. Maybe I'll make a couple of adjustments to the piece here, see if we can't get it to stop sooner. Well, I adjusted the float. So it's kind of a tough angle, but when I
bring it all the way up to where it stops. The float is even with the bottom of the carb, so I think that's where it needed to be. So let's see if that will do the trick and hopefully stop it from overflowing.
All right, so we've got the Hillbilly gas tank set up. It looks like the float adjustment did the trick because I don't see any fuel coming out of it now. Was some coming out of the fuel line as well where it went into the barb, but that zip tie is holding it in just enough. I need to replace that fuel line anyway. It didn't appear it was the appropriate size, so let's give it a shot now.
So here's something I'm suspecting. When I opened this up, this piece was just laying there. Those two little spots appeared that it held it on. They were pressed on. For some reason, they're not holding on anymore. So it was actually sitting in the bowl like that. And it was keeping the float down, which allowed all the fuel to still fill up. Don't really know what it does. If anybody knows, put in the comments, I'd be curious. I'm assuming since it goes to this vent hole that it maybe protects it from splashing, the fuel from splashing out. Lets a little bit of air in, but won't let any fuel out from splashing. I don't know, we'll find out, but I'm not going to put it back in. I figured, I guess worst case scenario, if it does in fact catch on fire, I just get off of it and that's the end of it. So let's get this back on and we'll see if we can finally have a consistently running machine. Well, let's put the carb back on again. I'm getting really good at this. Got the carb back on, all put back together. Got the fuel tank back on. So now that we have it all on, let's see if
That does it. I'm going to turn off the petcock first. We'll see if it takes it. Well, it was leaking, but after the tap, it stopped leaking, so I think a carb rebuild kit might be in the future for this thing. But let's give it a pull and see how it runs. It's definitely flooded, so I got to keep the throttle open. Well, there you have it. We got it running. Can't get it driving, obviously, but I think I was pretty successful. Let's try to get it cleaned up and try to get the carb back together as well as the gas tank. So thanks again. Take care. Bye.